Today's teacher read aloud is titled John Pemberton, Coca-Cola Developer by Sheila Griffin Llanas. Georgia Childhood. Today, Coca-Cola is a world-famous soda. More than 100 years ago, a pharmacist named Doc Pemberton invented the recipe as a medicine, but Coca-Cola tasted too good to be sipped just for headaches. As more people tasted it, Doc's medicine became a popular soft drink. John Stith Pemberton was born on January 8, 1831. His parents were Martha and James Clifford Pemberton. The family lived in Knoxville, which is in central Georgia. It was a small town, but it sat on a stagecoach route between Washington, D.C. and New Orleans, Louisiana. Soon the Pembertons moved to Rome in northwestern Georgia. John grew up in a time when the United States was still new. In his home state, settlers traveled on horseback, in wagons, or by stagecoach. Soon, steamboats and trains made stops in John's town. He saw the country change. Industrial growth led to many new inventions. His famous soda would be one of them. Family and career. Pemberton did not plan to be a food inventor. He hoped to be a doctor. He graduated from the Reform Medical College of Georgia in Macon in 1850. He earned a license to practice medicine at just 19 years old. For a time, he worked as a surgeon, but his true interest was medical chemistry. So later, he earned a graduate degree in pharmacy in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. In 1853, Pemberton married Anne Eliza Clifford, Cliff Lewis, of Columbus, Georgia. The couple's only son, Charles Ney, was born the next year. They bought a house in Columbus on November 20, 1855, for $1,950. In 1855, Pemberton founded a wholesale and retail drug business. He sold the ingredients that were used to make medicines. In Pemberton's era, many medicines were based on herbal home remedies. Unfortunately, like many others, Pemberton's career and family life were interrupted when the Civil War began in 1861. Pemberton enlisted in May 1862 and served as a lieutenant colonel in the Confederate Army. He organized the 3rd Georgia Cavalry Battalion to help defend his town. At the end of the war, Pemberton was wounded in the Battle of Columbus. The Union attacked on Easter Sunday, April 16, 1865. Pemberton suffered both gunshot and sword wounds. Afterward, he tried to put the war behind him. He returned to his laboratory. In the lab. The year before the war began, Pemberton had founded J.S. Pemberton & Company of Columbus. His lab became known as the best in the country. He also helped run at least 2 drugstores. At the time, drugstores often contained soda fountains. These popular meeting places offered syrups mixed with carbonated water. Some were medicines, while others were cool, sweet drinks. Doc Pemberton used soda fountains to test new flavors to see what customers liked. In his lab, Pemberton mixed up potions used to relieve symptoms of illness. One he called Globe Flower Cough Syrup. This big seller helped with lung problems. His extract of Stillingia was used to treat ulcers and skin disorders. He also developed a popular perfume called Sweet Southern Bouquet. In addition, Pemberton made photography chemicals, hair dyes, and cosmetics at his lab. In 1870, business brought the Pembertons to Atlanta, Georgia. The war-torn city was rebuilding. Pemberton seized a chance to create something new. Historic recipe. Pemberton was a lifelong learner. In magazines, he read about new medical substances. Extracts of coca leaves and cola nuts were said to improve health. In 1885, he added them to a nerve tonic and headache cure he named French Wine Coca. He believed that it was his best invention. In December, he formed the Pemberton Chemical Company. 3 partners handled business and marketing. At the same time, the temperance movement was growing. Knowing this could hurt sales of his products, Pemberton began working on a new recipe that did not include wine. He wanted to be ready when Atlanta declared local prohibition in the summer of 1886. Into a 3-legged brass kettle, Pemberton poured extracts of cola nuts and coca leaves. Lime, orange, vanilla, nutmeg, lemon, and other secret oils added flavor. He cooked his brew over a fire, stirring it with a wooden paddle as big as an oar. He filtered the sauce and let it ripen. Throughout the winter and spring of 1886, Pemberton sent his mixtures to Jacob's Pharmacy in downtown Atlanta for taste testing. Pemberton still thought of his syrup as a medicine. He called it an intellectual beverage and temperance drink. His business partner Frank Robinson came up with a better idea. He named it Coca-Cola, after coca leaves and cola nuts. It used two C's because Robinson thought they looked nice for ads. The syrup had a great flavor, a catchy name, and a nice logo. Coca-Cola was ready to sell. Refreshing! Jacob's Pharmacy served the very first fountain Coca-Cola. On May 8, 1886, Coca-Cola went on sale there. An ounce of delicious caramel syrup was mixed with sparkling bubbly water. Customers could buy a glass of Coca-Cola at the soda fountain for 5 cents. On May 29th, Coca-Cola's first advertisement appeared in the Atlanta Journal. Coca-Cola was promoted as delicious, refreshing, exhilarating, invigorating. Soon, big banners hung over pharmacy doors. They read, "Drink Coca-Cola, 5 cents," so people knew the product was a new beverage they should try. Pemberton insisted Coca-Cola was a medicine. His brain tonic relieved headaches, and he called it my temperance drink. But for Robinson, it was a delicious soda. He wanted to focus on promoting it. But when Prohibition ended in Atlanta in 1887, Pemberton returned his focus to French wine coca instead. The real thing. Today, Coca-Cola is the world's largest beverage company, and Coke is the best-known soft drink. The company's global headquarters is still in Atlanta. Doc Pemberton's recipe is still top secret. Coca-Cola has a simple principle. For a small price, customers get a moment of refreshment, but it happens more than 1 billion times a day. The company now owns many brands. Sprite, Dr. Pepper, Fanta, Minute Maid, and Dasani are all on the list. Coke is sold in more than 200 countries. Worldwide, the company employs more than 700,000 people. Many events led to Coca-Cola's historic success, but it all began with a medical recipe. Dr. John Pemberton created the Coca-Cola taste. With hard work, he contributed greatly to the field of medicine. He never imagined the enormous success of his brain tonic. The Coca-Cola Company has not forgotten him. A statue of Doc Pemberton stands outside the World of Coca-Cola, located at Pemberton Place in Atlanta. It honors the efforts of a popular pharmacist who made Coca-Cola possible. The World of Coca-Cola in Atlanta, Georgia is a really fun place to learn more about John Pemberton and his invention, Coca-Cola. My wife and I got the chance to visit there in November 2019. Not only can you see the statue of Doc Pemberton, but you also get to see the vault where the original Coca-Cola recipe is locked away. On top of that, you can also taste many different Coca-Cola products from all over the world. If you ever get the chance, you should check out this fun museum.